Hi, welcome to the summary of week 4. This is the scheme that we have discussed together. It is meant to help you understanding the big picture behind the PD, the probability of default. By the way, it's probably redundant, but probability of default and default probability are exactly the same thing, just two different ways of calling it. During the last classes, we have considered credit ratings. We have seen external ratings and internal ratings. Typically, the adjective external is not used. When you listen to the word ratings, most people refer to external ratings, that is, those ratings that are given by rating agencies, such as Fitch, for example. On the contrary, we always say internal ratings to indicate those ratings that are not acquired from rating agencies. For what concerns external ratings, we have said that every rating agency has its own rating scale, but that the ratings of the top three agencies, Moody's, Standard & Poor's, and Fitch, are considered comparable. Ratings fully determine the probability of default of a counterparty. We have seen that, even if ratings are always related to a specific bond issue or another type of security, most of the times, all the bonds issued by the same company have the same rating. That is why we can associate ratings to companies. Ratings are used to define if a security is in the investment grade or in the speculative grade. We have also seen that rating agencies provide transition matrices, giving information about the possibility that, say, a AAA bond is downgraded to AA, and tables containing the cumulative probability of default for every rating class. Then, we have considered internal ratings. Internal ratings are computed by banks and companies themselves. They are used when external ratings are not available, as in the case of small and medium enterprises. However, the internal rating approach allows banks to use internal ratings whenever they want, provided that the model they use is statistically sound. An important example of internal ratings method is Altman Z-score, which is based on discriminant analysis. Most internal ratings methods are just modifications of the original Z-score. Finally, we have considered recovery rates. Most of the times, when our counterparty defaults, we do lose some money, but not all the money. The recovery rate is the percentage amount of money at face value that we are able not to lose. And that's it. See you next time. Goodbye.